but this is
Sergeant Pepper's. We hope you will enjoy the show.
Yeah! What's going on, guys? JD here. Welcome back to History in the Mix. And today, it's going to be a sad one. It's going to be a sad one. Before we get into that, I want to talk about something happy over this little break. You guys know that I'm a, not impersonator, but I do dance from time to time. I recently got to do it again for these guys that came to school. It was called Challenge Day. It was really cool. I'll link their Instagram and stuff down below, and I really recommend you guys check them out. Inspirational stuff. It was honestly, it's kind of like a counseling thing, but it was so great, and it opened my eyes so much, and it's so great. But at the end, they played Thriller, and without any warning, I figured I should bust a few moves. But Thriller was not on film, so thanks for getting this part on film. Billie Jean is on film. Yeah, you know, that moonwalk, I kind of cut it quick because, you know, I kind of messed up. But today we're going to be talking about one of my favorite Michael Jackson songs of all time, You Rock My World. It's actually my favorite short film of all time just because it's so good. It's shot so well. I can't get over it. But Michael Jackson's makeup artist, Karen Fay, actually revealed some behind the scenes stories recently that I just had to tell you guys about and kind of spread along. I also would like to say that this video is called Michael Jackson's Breakdown, and I don't want to say breakdown is like a bad thing or overreacting. When I read this story, I saw a breakdown. This isn't monetized. I don't really monetize. I'm trying to get into monetizing, but even if that does happen and I get monetized down the road, this video will not be monetized, because that's not what the point of today's video is. Smooth Criminal is great. The Way You Make Me Feel is great. A majority of Michael's short films are fantastic, but what puts You Rock My World over the edge, in my opinion, is its comedy.
Ooh, look at that.
Co-starring Chris Tucker, Marlon Brando, and more, it's just a fun time. Michael is seen happy, laughing, and enjoying life, but apparently it wasn't all like that behind the scenes. Before we get into that, though, let me give you guys some background. The video was done in 2001 to promote the Invincible album. I'm sure you guys know, but Sony Music pulled all promotion for the album after Michael Jackson refused to go on tour.
Why are you the way that you are?
Due to this, Michael was on his own. He held various things like signings and even launching the same album in different colors.
And I'm lacking a lot in my collection.
Just to try to break even. You Rock My World was the first single released off the album. This was supposed to be the big comeback from history that came out around 5 years earlier. Even the release of this single had drama, due to the fact that Michael wanted Unbreakable to be released first. Michael loved Unbreakable, stating in a radio interview it was his favorite song off the album.
My favorite song on the new album. Can I pick two?
Yeah, I think you could do that. You can pretty much do whatever you like.
It would probably be Unbreakable. I'll pick three. Unbreakable, Speechless, and The Lost Children.
But Sony decided to release You Rock My World first because, and this is just a guess, it sounded like a normal Michael song. Something to the tune of The Way You Make Me Feel. Unbreakable is closer to rap, and audience would have just been confused. And Sony was right, because You Rock My World was Mike's last number one hit to top various charts during his lifetime. Even though a video was supposed to be done for Unbreakable, Sony's baby, I mean, You Rock My World, got the film treatment. The video was directed by Paul Hunter, and consists of Michael and his good friend and star of the Rush Hour trilogy.
Do you understand the words that are coming out of my mouth?
And they try to gain a woman's attention by following her around in a club-type bar. While there, they run into some trouble by a gang, which honestly looks more like a pimp ring.
What are you doing, baby?
Ran by Marlon Brando. Here's a little fun fact. The big dance performed during the video consists of fragments from the canceled Dangerous music video from 1993. Okay, this is where it's gonna get kinda hard, and a lot of people are gonna get butt hurt. It's no secret that Michael didn't look great around this time. He didn't look healthy, he didn't look happy. That's just, there's no denying that. Professional plastic surgeon Pamela Lipkin told ABC News around this time that Michael had a, quote, nasal cripple. I've done some research on a nasal cripple, and it is defined as, quote, one's nose who has been done so many times that there is no nose really to breathe through. After realizing this, Paul Hunter took it in his own hands to tell Michael what he thought was the truth. This is kind of where I want to appear neutral, because you guys know History in the Mix, neutral show, I don't favor any side. But I do want to say that this entire story is told from the point of view of Karen Fay. I tried reaching out to Paul Hunter's directing company kind of thing. I figured I wouldn't get a response. I asked for a comment or something, but they refused to comment. So this is all told from the point of view from Karen Fay. And I really wish I had some of Paul Hunter's insight. I tried, but I couldn't get it. So this is all done by Karen Fay. First, we need to refer to this picture done by a fan, which Karen quoted on Twitter and legitimized. The picture says, quote, in the short film You Rock My World, they, referring to Paul Hunter and other people we'll get to later, wanted Michael to darken his skin and remold his nose a little.
What you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard. I award you no points, and may God have mercy on your soul.
Shortly after hearing this, Michael locked himself in the bathroom and began to break everything. Quote, Paul Hunter called me the night before the shoot and told me he needed to darken his skin and add prosthetics to enlarge his nose. I asked if Michael approved of this, and he said he did not ask him. I told him that it would break MJ's heart if he brought this up. I told him that under no circumstances would I ask MJ. If he wanted this, then he, Paul, would have to ask. First off, how humiliating would this be? I mean, Michael already read it. He already knew that he thought he looked weird, and they said he looked weird, but to get that, to not even be able to be in your own video, like you really are, that just really sucks, you know? And I can only imagine what somebody like Michael would go through. Just stop dogging me around. If you know me in real life, I'm really self-conscious and stuff like that. I don't like to make eye contact. I'm really bad at all stuff like that. And Michael was too. And to get this, oh my God, I don't blame him at all for doing what he did. Quote, Michael was so distraught and shaken, the shoot was canceled that day. I had never seen him that hurt and out of control in all the years and all the tragedy he previously endured. It was Trudy Green. She goes on to mention somebody named Trudy Green, who I tried to do research about, and I even asked her about it, but I didn't get a response. And I tried to Google her, and all I could find is that she's some type of music manager. So I don't really know what she was to Michael. If anybody wants to put that down in the comments, which I know you will, I know I'll get a bunch of comments saying, you're so stupid. But Trudy Green, yeah. Paul Hunter and Trudy plotted behind MJ's back to change his appearance. Man, and keep in mind, Sony hired these people. Michael didn't hire these people. She goes on later to state something I didn't really put in, some kind of ad-libbing, that Paul Hunter hired the chick that you see in the video. Usually people like Naomi Campbell from In the Closet and people like that, Michael would find. Michael would find people that he was comfortable with, but they did not ask him for You Rock My World. They just pick somebody.
And wonders if it was fun for you to make the rock, the You Rock My World video.
Yes, that was a lot of fun. we stayed up all night working very hard. it was fun hearing it blasted on the set on really big speakers. That's one of my favorite things.
And to finish off this terrifying and depressing story, quote, the highlight for us was when Marlon Brando screamed, go, yourself, to Paul Hunter on the set in front of everyone. Michael even loved it. You Rock My World was completely hijacked by Sony and Trudy Green from him. The only happiness for him on that shoot was Chris Tucker and Marlon Brando.
Keep it to yourself! Have it! You're like a weed fooling you!
You Rock My World was one of the most painful short films to work on. Wow, this story... Wow. I find it very disrespectful. Paul Hunter is actually quite successful in the music video realm. I was doing some research on him. He did videos for Britney Spears and I think even Janet. And I feel like he's a normal Hollywood director. I feel like any director, that's kind of what you get. I mean, a lot of directors Michael used, like John Landis, they were friends with Michael and they wouldn't tell Michael no. And I feel like sometimes Michael needed to be told no.
No, God, please, no, no! No!
And I feel like Paul Hunter, instead of saying no or wanting him to put on makeup, just randomly, you know, just did it himself. Karen Faye goes more into detail, stating that sometimes people showed up on set and wanted to take a mold of Michael's face, which, you don't know, he did that in Thriller and Moonwalker, just kind of practice makeup. And he kept asking Karen, like, why are they doing this to me? And Karen wouldn't tell. And then Michael eventually got mad, and Karen told him. And he was just so distraught and did the things that we talked about earlier about screaming and throwing stuff. And it's humiliating and it's embarrassing, and just all the respect in the world for Michael for going through and pushing through that. God, it's just so, such a bad story and such an awkward story that I'm sure I'll get a lot of hate on. But I just feel like I had to cover this to tell you guys that Michael was human. And it goes back to that counseling thing I was talking about earlier. This is such a great story. I actually got on stage and was able to talk about Michael a little bit. I'm gonna go into that. They played Man in the Mirror to end it. They told us, like, hey, if there's anybody that wants to share, go ahead. And I raised my hand, and I don't usually talk a lot. And the first thing I said was, they were talking about, like, leaders in Man in the Mirror play. And I said, like, you know, there's leaders, and one reason I really look up to Michael, and then I point to the speaker, is because they called him a pedophile. They called him these things. They said he didn't want it to be who he was. And he pushed through and continued to achieve, and that's why we need to push through. That's why we can't judge people. That's why we need to see what they're going through and then talk about their problems. Whether, you know, a lot of people don't go through or look at Michael's medical history about falling. And then that's when he got the first nose job, around off the wall time. He fell, he was dancing, he fell. But they don't know that. They just see a white Michael Jackson. And that's what's really sad, and that's why I want to do this video. It's not to make fun of Michael. It's not to talk about Michael's plastic surgery. It's to talk about how Michael Jackson was a human and how he needs to be viewed as such. And probably not right. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe for more. Thanks to Karen Faye. I kind of feel bad. I kind of like ripped off this entire video from her. Yeah, this is not monetized again. Again, thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe for more. And remember, make that change while you got the time, you got the go, you got.
Hello, this is Michael Jackson. Thank you so much for being here. More to come. Keep checking in.